Will you look at this? Bill Gatta Jr. will be so proud. Oh, you know, he does an excellent job with that smoker that he built. You know, and this is so easy for an old guy, especially when the weather is like it is right now. Oh, man. Burnt ends in the cast iron skillet. Can you see that? I probably can't see it. I'm going to put that in the oven and warm them up. Oh, so good. I fall under the conventional oven. Yeah, under these conditions. 13 to 15 minutes. Yeah, remove cover and cook additional 13 to 15 minutes or until the product is 140 drawn off any excess liquid. And then I will add the barbecue sauce. And this is Kansas City style. It is so good. It comes from Sam's Club. Yeah, $20. I'll tell you, 2 pounds for $20. You price that at a restaurant? Yeah, $20 is cheap. Will you look at that? A Crawdaddy Forge knife. Yeah, you can see the maker's mark. Yeah, you can see it's well used. Yes, the maker's mark is almost gone because of the patina. Let's see if this is done. It's so nice to use a sharp knife. Oh yeah, look at that. Look. Look at the goodness, it is so tender. Can you see that? This is what I call my hot salad. I like to serve this right over the top of that steak. There's onions, mushrooms, garlic, peppers, Yeah, I got sweet peppers, nothing hot. No, yeah, good. I could put hot, but I'm gonna cook this down just a little bit until this gets gooey and the peppers get, and the onions get soft. Oh, so good. Zucchini with multi-blend cheese on top. Yes, yes, it's better than any potato. Thank you, Mark. I don't know if you can see that in the video or not, but that is a Crawdaddy Forge Nussmuck knife. Look at the goodness. Oh my. Taste the goodness. Are you concerned, my friend? Are you concerned? There might be a bite or two for you? You think? Yeah. Bill Gowdy and Lucy Lou. We're checking in right on the Mississippi River. Pool 19, catching a few catfish. But I gotta tell you another Lucy story. Every time I tell a story, I'll catch a fish. I'm hoping that works this time. We shall see. She's worse than a kid. Uh-oh, got a bite, gotta go. Nice hand fryer. Yeah, look at that. Well, it worked. All I have to do is turn on the camera and not talk about fishing, and I start catching fish. Got some pan fryers. They're biting on night crawlers today. But back to Lucy's story. She's worse than a kid. So the other day, around the where my truck camper sewer line exit is, there was some, I don't know if they're paper wasp, they're some kind of wasp, and Lucy didn't like it. They were buzzing around that waste thing, and Lucy's going snapping at them. Yeah, sure enough, she got stung. Yeah, I think she got stung in the mouth. She was hacking and, you know, just, and actually shaking. I was worried. I gave her some Benadryl and kept her quiet, and she slowed way down. She just rested, and she was shaking. I mean, she just was, you know. But I Googled it, and they said, don't worry. You know, dogs swallow bumblebees and other bees all the time. Well, Lucy doesn't, but I think she learned her lesson. She doesn't go by that sewer pipe anymore. That sewer drain, anyway. Uh-oh, I gotta go. I'll be back. Thank you. Well, I was blessed. There are 8 channel catfish. I don't know. The biggest one is 2 pounds, probably. Right there, 2-pounder. And then there's 1 flathead, probably 1.5 pounds. 1 drum, I'll weigh him. He's probably, I don't know, he's probably 2.5 pounds, 3. I don't know. He's pretty good size. I hope he looks good because I'd like to have some more of that poor man's shrimp. Yeah, to boil him. Oh, he's so good. I just love those size, those pan fryers. Look at this little small little carp. Those have quite a history around here. Carp are not considered a good fish in our part of the river. They have quite a history across the world though. But these kind of carp came in the 1800s. But the Asian carp, they came in the 70s. And they're both considered invasive species, and they get tons of these fish in the river now. But the Asian carp are the jumpers, are the ones that don't like the boat motors running. But this is not an Asian carp, this is just a regular standard carp. You're not supposed to throw them back, because there's too many of them in there. They're treated less, you know, not like a game fish or anything. So, you know what, rather than throw them back, yeah, I'll eat them. And I, you know, you got a lot of bones, but I know how to deal with it. So, yeah, and they're good to eat, especially those young ones, even better. This part of the video is for Calvin's Corner 72. He wanted to know and wanted to see what a parasite looks like. Well, there's 2 types that I see most commonly in my scale fish, and this is one of them, and I can't remember what the name of it is, but it's a little yellow worm, and this one I've only cleaned half. I filleted him out. I'll rinse him off, but they grow, it grows in the muscle. Then there's another type that looks like black pepper, little peppers. They're just in the muscle. And if it got too many of them, I just throw it away. If it's just 1 or 2 little pouches like that, I can just easily cut those out, rinse it off. You know what? And if you forget it, the conservation officer that used to be here, he retired. But he said it didn't make no difference. You could cook them and eat them anyway. But, you know, who wants to eat parasites? I don't. And you don't want to make sure you cook it thoroughly. So I just cut them out, you know. And yeah, this freshwater drum looks, so far is looking real good, but I don't see any. I don't see anything in there. I'll look closer without the camera. I'm gonna give you a warning, if you don't like blood and guts, don't look at this part, but this is where the lucky stones are. Other people ask, and Calvin did too, asked about, right here's the eye, here's the brain, and on either side of the brain you find their lucky stone. Yeah, and there's an L on one side, and I guess it, I don't know if you want to call it, they got a little etching on each side. It looks like an L match. Pretty nice size stones. Okay, I want to show you the difference between the flathead catfish, that's what this is, and you can see this is the inside of the stomach, inside of the cavity where all the organs are, and how nice and white and clean that is. It's the type of food that it eats. Here is what a channel catfish looks like. It has a silver lining on there, and this is where a lot of strong taste comes from. And I like to wash that out. That's a little secret. Not everybody, you know, when you buy your fish from the market, that won't come scrubbed out. And I'm telling you, you want to scrub that out. And I've been to restaurants that they don't scrub them out, and they just bread them up and cook them just like that. That can cause your fish to have a lot stronger taste. Let me show you. I use a little finger scrub brush like this. I run clear fresh water on it. How nice and white that is now. So much better. And I tell you what, the flavor is so much better too if you're going to eat that part. It is so good. Here's a channel catfish. Here's a flathead catfish. Very nice. The only thing I do with the flathead is I get that blood out of there. That nice? I can taste it already. Little secret. The next thing I do before I fry these up, I'll cut these. I'll just notch them. I'll just slice it down to the backbone all the way. And it makes it cook faster and better. And then some of the coating. I'm going to use 3-2-1 coating, but whatever coating you use will get down in that crack and it just cooks in and just has so much flavor. Here's one more little secret I do. I'll show you. On my hole fryers, there's a little nerve that runs around along this lateral line here. And I don't know if you can see that pulling, but it's pulling all the way down and pull all the way out. I take that out. There's one on each side. I think I already took this one out, but you'll see it when you clean them. You'll see it hanging out. Just pull on it. Just pull on it and it'll come out. Thank you.
just full of adventure today. Caught some catfish this morning, and drum and carp. Going to do a little shooting this afternoon. Going to cook up some fish tonight. Fresh fish, you can't beat it. Today I want to show you something from my past. It's an H&R. I don't know if that'll read or not. It's an H&R 926. They made these from, I believe the internet said, that from 1973 to 1978. This, I bought this brand new in 1977. It's got an AR beginning on the serial number, and according to the things that I saw on the internet, that it was manufactured in 1977. It's in really good shape. You can see that it's a break action. It's got a manual. It's 9-shot. It's a double action and a single action. And it's got a bodacious double action pull. But let's shoot it. I'll be shooting these. I got a box of Winchester 33s. I've had them for a long time. Like a lot of the stuff I've had around here. But they ought to work. Well, there's 9 shots from about 7 yards. You can see it's shooting low. Actually, I'm aiming right here and shooting a little bit low at 7. Well, let's shoot it some more. I haven't shot it for years. And that is double action trigger pull. It is ragged. All right, as you can see, it's unloaded. Back here is the adjustment for the windage left to right, which it's right on the money. Up here, right on the front of the barrel, is the adjustment to raise or lower that sight. It's hinged right here and it goes up or down. That's how you adjust the sights on this. Kind of dangerous, I guess. I mean, as long as you do it while it's unloaded, you know, it's not dangerous at all, but you know, it's not your, the average sights are adjustable in the back and you never have to look down the barrel of the gun. But yeah, all in all, it's a good shooter. It's got a ragged double action trigger pull, but you know what, if you can shoot this gun, yeah, you can master about any kind of gun. All right, this is my first set of targets, and then I adjusted the sights. Got my group up a little bit. So 7 yards with those Winchester rounds. I adjusted the sights, and now I got them all, yeah, right where I want them. I'm happy. All right. I hope you enjoyed this. This was fun. I need to get out and do some more, bring you along on some more of my barbecue and shooting, I guess. Maybe some camping and shooting. We'll see. That's all my empty breasts. Yeah, I like to keep the range clean. I don't like to litter, even though these aren't reloadable. I like to throw these away properly or recycle them properly. It's brass, you know.
Look at the goodness. I can certainly smell that Texas tea. Oh, smells so good. Look at the goodness. Notice how those are cut?
Yes.
Awesome. Awesomeness. Well, you look at this. There is the 321 coating with the Texas peat dust. There is a 321 coating without the Texas peat dust. Both are dark. Yeah, they get dark. They get darker. Let's try it. Let's see what it does. Oh, wow. Yeah, there's no heat, but you can definitely taste. You know, I've noticed that the heat gets cooked out every time. So if you want spiciness, you have to add it after you cook it. If you want to try to cook it with the spice, the heat goes away. Yeah, I mean, that's my option, or, you know, my observation. Wow. That's good too. I like them both. Thank you, Melissa. This is some good stuff. Well, you know what the sign says. Yeah, it is good. And they say so. You can't use too much of this stuff. It is good. You probably can't see that, but oh, the goodness. Thank you, Crawdaddy Forge. Get you one. Thank you.